Hello there, gorgeous ladies and gentlemen. My name is Art and I'm addicted to film photography and I need help. Just kidding. So as you guys already know from the title that this video is made for a book review for our English week, and this does not directly related to English book or the use of language in this case, but I find that this would be a perfect opportunity to show you guys how this particular book got me into photography, as well as a golden opportunity to show some of my photos to our viewers as well. It was in February 2020 when I was just like every one of you out there, trying to kill the time by looking for a book to read in the school library. And from the corner of my eye, I found this book on the shelf that has been around our school since 1977. Call me a psychopath, but I actually sniffed on it and it smells just like the 70s. The Portrait of Hong Kong by Edward Spud. This book is a showcase of the pictures of Hong Kong taken by Edward Smart himself, as well as some basic guidelines to frame the picture and the fundamentals of photography, which gave me an introduction to analog photography. I was awed by the uniqueness and the aura of film pictures that is impossible to duplicate from any digital formats. Feeling inspired like never before, spending hours and hours with that book appreciating the beauty of Hong Kong that was captured on 35mm film, absorbing the details and the instructions as much as I could. This process is called analog photography. Analog photography, the process of creating an image chemically by controlling the amount of light passing through the lens that then hits the light sensitive film. The emulsion on the film then reacts to the light, a bit like getting burned, and engraves a physical picture on itself. That picture can be developed and saved with a chemical developing process, while digital, on the other hand, have made this process far easier, faster, and generally more efficient by using a light sensitive sensor instead of a film. The sensor then measures the light information and saves it on a digital storage unit, such as an SD card. The reason why the author of the book that I choose, Edward Smart himself, choose film over digital is because of the slowed down process really. There is a lot of reasons to shoot film, but the big part of it is that it feels slower than digital camera that you can get today. And when I say slow, I mean really slow. There's this immediacy with digital cameras that I feel like takes away from taking photos a lot of the time. He stated that when you're shooting photos, you want to be thinking about what you are taking photos of. So for me with film, you shoot the photos and you might see it in a week or even months later. And you really have to spend that time to think about what you have shot. And there's also this unbiased approach. If I shoot a photo and I see it right away at the back of my camera, my digital camera, the excitement of being in a moment still has like a biased impact on how I feel about that picture. But if I look at it 2 months later or even years later, I feel like I have a more open-minded approach too. And I can really see like, oh, this isn't really that great, or I could be like, oh, this turned out really well. And when shooting film, there's also a little bit of patience before you press the shutter. That I think goes a long way when you take a film image, because you just put much more thought into your photo since every shot will cost you money. Like, is this really what I want? Is this exactly how you want to frame your picture? Is this really about the subject I'm interested in? In that way, it has definitely made me just interested in the subjects that I'm photographing. I do believe that there's a lot of things that people walk by every day that they don't really observe, that just in an act of noticing, this can make it beautiful because you notice it. You know, it's the simple pleasure of noticing something and capture it at the exact moment. Edward Smart himself also mentioned that sometimes, if I'm walking down with a camera in my hand, I just walk by a tree, a simple tree that I wouldn't have looked at if that camera was in my hand. I mean, of course, I would want to show all of my pictures that I have taken, but that would probably take days or even weeks to do so, since I've already have like 100,000 of them already. And some of you may ask why I always take so many pictures, especially in daily lives and events that are not special at all. To me personally, I just strongly believe that most of the time, people only take pictures only on the big and memorable events, when it is already easy to look back on. But taking pictures on regular things that happen every day with friends and families or whoever are often overlooked, but always hit the hardest when you look back on. Every time I get my film developed, I feel like a Christmas morning with all of your faces and smiles on it. So don't let the world change your smile, but make your smile change the world. Thank you for your time and have a good day ahead, everyone.